everyone. I am Pender Natalia Alexandrovna, senior lecturer of Foreign Languages and Literature Division of Sakhtagan Bayashev University. Today we're going to speak about interactive technologies and teaching a foreign language. This topic is of great value because now we teach the students of that generation. We're going to speak about two main questions: interactive technologies and teaching a foreign language, and benefits of using interactive technologies in language learning. So to start with, I need to remind you a kind of saying: tell me and I'll forget. That is what was done in many of the schools and many educational systems for many, many centuries. The teachers were the only persons who gave the students ready-made knowledge. Show me and I may remember. Very often in the lessons we show some samples, we show how to do this or that, but it doesn't work. And involve me and I'll understand. Really, that is the principle that we follow nowadays in educational process, in educational system. So this learning pyramid is of great value. A look at this pyramid and you will see. So just on the top of the pyramid, you see lecture. So, and 0% is given here. So when we conduct the lecture, in many, many cases, students don't remember what we were speaking about because they were not involved. Reading, if the students read some material that we suggest them to do, only 10% of the material is assimilated. Audiovisual, 20%. Demonstration, 30%. Discussion, 50. Look, 0 when we conduct the lecture, and 50 when the students discuss. Why? Because the students are involved in the process and they need to remember what they read, what they heard, what they saw, and to apply it into practice. Practice doing 75%. It's more, but still not 100. And teach others 90%. Why? Here, when we teach others, we combine consultation with on-site customized training and teaching, and the results are optimal. So what do we do when we teach others? We need to use all the materials, all the knowledge we got, and to apply it into practice. And at the same time, we need to know how to do it. So, achieving important goals through interaction. Interaction, the word itself means doing together. Here, the main thing for the teacher, you need to remember that what you want. I want all my students to become engaged in the learning process and passionate about the subject matter. My classes to be fun and meaningful at the same time. It doesn't matter what students we teach. Primary school students, secondary school students, high school students, or students of colleges and universities. The whole process must be very interesting for the students. It must be fun. No one tells that we must play with the students of colleges or universities or even high school, but the material that you select, the way you present the material must be interesting enough for students to be involved and to see that it's fun. So I want my students to learn to work together. That is, we need to teach our students collaborative learning. And it can be taught only through interaction. To form positive and respectful relationship with my students, between students, that will allow them to learn more effectively. Again, we're speaking about collaboration. So all these points that you see on the screen so shows that only in this case, if you have these objectives, if you have these goals, you will achieve all the goals of teaching foreign language through interaction. That is, we need organizing the lessons, the lectures, practical lessons. We need to think about engagement, fun, working together, and positive relationship. Let's have a look at some examples of interactive teaching methods or activities. Brainstorming, I'm sure you know what it is. Ranking exercises, small group discussions, role plays, questions and answers, simulations, debates, games, hypothetical problems, open-ended stimulus, snowball, Participant presentation, storytelling, problem solving, jigsaw, teach one, visual aids. Now let's discuss some of them. Practice makes perfect. To achieve goals and to have good results, you need to practice a lot. Information gap activity. Learners exchange information that only one of them has. Information gap, find someone who. It's a commonly used activity. Here you have a kind of table, question, for example, who has been abroad? Who has visited any Asian cities? Who has taken any school trip? The students need to mingle around the class to ask the question, have you been abroad? Have you visited any Asian cities? And so on and so forth. And to put the names of the students, they got a positive answer. Here, with the help of this activity, you can practice whatever you like. Vocabulary, grammar, or something else. Another activity is very interesting. You see the directions here, north, east, west, south, and middle, north, east, south, east, southwest, northwest, and the task that the students may have. You have information that your partner needs and vice versa in order to complete the map with the missing information. Use the expressions under to help each other complete task. Do not show the map to each other. That means that two students have quite different information, but both of them need the information of the others to complete their task. Here you see the map and partner A. What state is located in the northwest? Washington is located in the northwest. What state is located in the south? Texas is situated in the south. So by the end of the activity, both of them will have completed information. Bingo! Some teachers say that this activity is very efficient and useful for the students of the primary school. No. The students, even at the universities, they like to play this. They seem it to be a game, but it's a very serious activity. Here, for example, bingo based on the recognition or remembering three forms of the verbs. Students sit in a round table. Each student gets three cards. The goal is to collect three forms of the verb by passing extra card. And if the student who gets three forms of any regular verb is the winner. And he usually shouts, bingo! Storytelling. Of course, this activity is very useful for the students not of the primary, not the first grade, but starting with the second grade, it's okay. Students work in groups and write down six qualitative adjectives. We have six sentences, and their task will be to complete. Fill in the gaps with these adjectives in order you have written. For example, for the students, our December courses. Once, you need to put an adjective, teachers started the qualification courses. For example, once newly made teachers. They took part in online seminars and webinars. Some lectures were, others were not. The teachers prepared magnificent projects, for example. At last, all teachers became well prepared. Interactive methods are beneficial to the learning process of the human mind. They develop our thinking. Turn students into active participants. It's very, very important. Do you remember? Involve me and I understand everything. And form universal learning activities. To broaden your knowledge on the topic, you can read the materials given here. And I am sure that when you go to a pedagogical practice or when you become teachers, when you graduate the university, you will use this material in your teaching practice.